excited to know more about Karies, how he started liking bananas. Yes, we all like bananas, don't we? Yeah, it's very nutritious food. Now, we'll also see the other traits of Kari in the second part. We don't stop reading, we read it loud so that we can enhance our reading skills, isn't it? Come along, students.
Grade 7, Subject English. A chapter, Bringing Up Kari. I'm your language teacher, Shanti Ma'am. Students, now we'll see a video on the topic Master Call.
Hello!
I'll throw some light on the word master call. I hope you have learnt it and done some research to know what is a master call. Let me explain. A master call is a strange hissing and howling sound which is made in the elephant's ear by his master. It is the most important signal for an elephant to learn because it is the way to find out the straight route to the house if the master is lost in the darkness of the jungle. So we have started developing empathy towards animals, isn't it? Today's instruction. We are going to enhance our reading skills, so we need to do a loud reading with intonation. We also need to infer the meaning of unfamiliar words and phrases. We will also identify the writer's point of view in the chapter. Word in focus. Steal. Steal is a verb meaning to rob something. Conjugation is steal, stole, stolen. Stealing, steals. Derivative. Steal is a noun. Usage. He stole all the gold kept in the locker. It's a verb usage. Now we continue our loud reading. Kari was like a baby. He had to be trained to be good. And if you did not tell him when he was naughty, he was up to more mischief than ever. For instance, one day somebody gave him some bananas to eat. Very soon, he developed a great love for ripe bananas. We used to keep large plates of fruits on the table near a window in the dining room. One day, all the bananas on the table disappeared, and my family blamed the servants for eating all the fruits in the house. A few days later, the fruits disappeared again. This time, the blame was put on me, and I knew I had not done it. It made me very angry with my parents and the servants. See here, the author was very angry with his parents and the servants. For I was sure that had taken all the fruit. The next time the fruit disappeared. The author says, I found a banana all smashed up in Kari's pavilion. This surprised me very much, for I had never seen fruit there, and as you know, he had always lived on twigs. Next day, while I was sitting in the dining room, wondering whether I should take some fruits from the table, The author was wondering whether he should take the fruit from the table. With my parents' permission, a long black thing, very much like a snake, suddenly came through the window and disappeared with all the bananas. I was very much frightened because I had never seen snakes eating bananas. Oh, look at the picture. The entire trunk, actually it's not a snake, it was the trunk. You can guess whose trunk it was. And I thought, it must be a horrible snake that would sneak in and take fruits. I crept out of the room and with great fear in my heart ran out of the house, feeling sure that the snake would come back into the house, eat all the fruits and kill all of us. So this was the imagination of the author. Do you feel the same? As I went out, I saw Curry back disappearing in the direction of the pavilion. And I was so frightened that I wanted his company to cheer me up. I ran after him into the pavilion and I found him there eating bananas. I stood watching him. Still in astonishment, the bananas were lying strewn all around him. Strewn, thrown here and there. Yes. He stretched out his trunk and reached for one far away from there where he was standing. Then instant, see the way Curry was eating his banana? Happily enjoying because he had a love for that fruit. The trunk looked like a black snake and I realized that Curry was the thief. I went to him, pulled him out by the ear and joyously showed my parents that it was not a black snake. It was who? Curry and not I that had eaten all the fruits these many weeks. Then I scolded him, for elephants understand words as well as children. And I said to him, next time I see you stealing fruit, you will be whipped. He knew that we were all angry with him, even the servants. His pride was so injured that he never stole another thing from the dining room. And from then on, if anybody gave him any fruit, he always squealed as if he thanked them. An elephant is willing to be punished for having done wrong, but if you punish him without any reason, he will remember it and pay you back in your own coin. Do you know? We are going to add few more details for Curry. Yes, he was a fast learner. So we learned the master call. Yes, his master all signals and sounds he is taught. So he mastered all the sounds and the signals. It was quite an exception. An elephant learns its master call. It takes it 5 years to learn it. There is one lesson though, an elephant is taken 5 years to learn. Curry was not an exception. See how the author pulled him? An elephant must be taught when to sit down, when to walk, when to go fast, and then when to go slow. You teach him these things as you teach a child. If you say dhat and pull him by the ear, he will gradually learn to sit down. Similarly, if you say mali and pull his trunk forward, he will gradually learn that it is the signal to walk. See the author holding him by his ear. Kari learned Mali after 3 lessons, but it took him 3 weeks to learn Dhat. He was no good at sitting down. And do you know why an elephant should be taught to sit down? Because he grows taller and taller than you who takes care of him. So that when he is 2 or 3 years old, you can only reach his back with a ladder. It is therefore better to teach him to sit down by saying Dhat, so that you can climb upon his back, for who would want to carry a ladder about all the time? The most difficult thing to teach an elephant is the master call. I've already discussed what is a master call. It's a hissing and a howling sound which is made by the elephant into the elephant's ears by the master. It's a very important signal, isn't it? Because then if the master is lost in the darkness, the elephant can reach home. The most difficult thing to teach an elephant is the master call. He generally takes 5 years to learn it properly. The master call is a strange hissing, howling sound, as if a snake or a tiger was fighting each other, and you have to make the kind of noise in his ears, and do not know what you expect an elephant to do when you give him the master call. If you are lost in the jungle and there is no way out and everything is black except the stars above, you dare not stay very long anywhere. The only thing to do then is to give the master call, and at once the elephant pulls down the tree in front of him with his trunk. This frightened all the animals away. As the tree comes crashing down, monkeys wake up from their sleep and run from branch to branch. See here, when Kari heard the master call, he pulled the trunk out and all the monkeys jumped from tree to tree to escape. You can see them in the moonlight, and you can almost see the stags running in all directions below. You can hear the growls of the tiger in the distance. Even he is frightened. When the elephant pulls down the next tree and the next and the next, soon you will find that he has made a road right through the jungle straight to your house. Isn't that an amazing fact about elephants? So we have learned many things about Kari and in general many facts about elephant. This lesson, the author is Dhan Gopal Mukherjee. You're seeing how Kari pulled all the branches and ultimately made a way from the forest till the author's house. Now, as we have read the chapter aloud, there are few questions which we can easily write. So pick up your classworks, go back to the reading, read the text aloud, and try to answer the questions given here in the PPT. If you have any doubts, please ask in the Google Classroom. So, students, I hope you will complete the task given to you. That's all for today, and bye from Shanti ma'am.
So in this entire chapter, my author Dhan Gopal Mukherjee has shown us how we can have empathy towards even a wild animal which lives in the jungle, the elephant, isn't it? Now, we have to not only have empathy towards wild animals, but animals that are around our house. So at least try to give some water to a sparrow or some food to a stray dog. In this way, we can develop empathy towards animals. So I hope everyone enjoyed the session of reading loud and enjoying the entire process of knowing about Kari the elephant. Thank you, students.